Have you ever wanted to control the brightness of your lights with just a simple switch or a knob? Or if I tell you that you are about to find a way to save some money on your energy bills while also extending the lifespan of your light bulbs? Hello everyone and welcome back to Element 14 Presents. I'm Surbhika and today I'm going to show you how I built an AC dimmer circuit that can control the brightness of your lights with ease. So no more fumbling over the light switches in the dark, just a smooth dimmable light that you can adjust to your heart's content. So if you are ready, let's just get started and dive into the build of this circuit. Just be very careful while touching any electronics parts during this project because we'll be handling with the AC main supply this time. Let's start with the basic principles behind the working of dimmer circuits. How do you think a little knob on your lamp or ceiling fans is able to provide controlled power to the AC loads? The answer to this is in the concept called phase angle control. It is a key to adjust the power delivered to a number of AC loads. Though there can be several techniques which can do this, such as resistance control, PWM method, or voltage regulation. But I would say the phase angle control is the most common and power efficient way to do this. If we had some DC load, then we would use pulse width modulation to deliver the average power. The duty cycle of PWM wave is adjusted to achieve controlled power with respect to the full scale at 100% duty cycle. It's a similar case for the AC loads and switches as well. But an additional timing information is also important. That is, we need to know when we turn the pulse on and off. By synchronizing the pulses with the AC waveform, the phase angle control circuit can accurately control the amount of current that flows through the load and therefore control the power delivered to the load. This allows the brightness of light bulb to be varied smoothly without flicker or noise and without generating excessive heat. It should also be ensured that the modulated output waveform has 0 DC value, means equal amounts of positive and negative portion of the supply should be delivered. The phase angle control or phase cutting circuit can be divided into two parts, one where we need an AC driver for the load and second where we need a timing reference to control this driver. At the heart of the driver circuitry, we use a device called triac. With triac, we can control the flow of AC current by turning it on and off at precise times. In a way, we adjust how much power we deliver to the load by choosing which part of each cycle of the sine wave is used to power the load. Check this simple simulation to understand how triacs can switch supply to the load. Here, S1 is a voltage controlled switch. When the switch is closed, the gate current of the triac rises to turn on the triac, so it passes the AC current through it. Until the switch is open again and the AC voltage across it goes down below a certain threshold. It means even if I remove the pulse after turning on the triac, it will still remain on until the next zero crossing. This brings me to the second part of the circuit. We said we needed timing information to synchronize the generation of this pulse which fires the triac. So zero crossings on the AC voltage waveform can work as that reference. If the microcontroller could detect the zero crossings, it can determine the set and reset time of the pulse output based on the dimming required by the user. I am using an optocoupler with the two anti-parallel LEDs at input to implement the zero crossing detector circuit. It generates a pulse each time the AC waveform crosses zero, which is then fed to a microcontroller. The resistor is selected to limit the current rating of optocoupler and power rating of the resistor itself. At the output of the optocoupler is an NPN transistor which is pulled up to fit the digital logic to the microcontroller. This is the SFH628 optocoupler IC. One of two LEDs are always forward biased for an alternating signal. Only time both the LEDs are in the off state is when the input waveform is within some threshold bounds of the zero crossing. This threshold depends upon the forward voltage of the diodes. Since the transistor's collector terminal is pulled up using 2.2K resistor, whenever zero crossing occurs, this turns off the otherwise on transistor. This signal is fed to the pico digital input pin. This is the driver circuit exactly like the one in simulation. Only change is that I replace the voltage control switch with optocoupler IC-MOC-3021 and the control pulse is being provided using Raspberry Pi Pico. To verify the driver circuit, I'm gonna provide a 1 Hz pulse and see if the AC bulb connected at the load blinks. Well, it does work. The bulb is blinking, so I can conclude that the driver circuit is working fine.
Hi, I'm Derek, and this is DC to Daylight, where we explore the world of electronics in the realm of DC, audio frequencies, RF, and into the visible spectrum of light. Here we take electrical engineering topics out of the boring old textbook and bring them into life through demonstration and test. Sometimes we even build stuff, and if there's a way to test the concept at hand, we'll put it on a scope and measure it, and in doing so, hopefully bring it to daylight. So if that sounds like a good time to you, come hang out with me every couple weeks here at Element 14 Presents. All right, see you there.
Now that I've connected the zero crossing detection pulse at the microcontroller input in interrupt mode and a potentiometer at one of the ADCs to get analog input for controlling the brightness level of the lights, here you can see the blue pulse is the control pulse given to the optocoupler. Its pulse width is varied using the potentiometer knob and we see that the voltage waveform across the load is chopped off to produce varying levels of RMS voltage to the load. The bulb used earlier is mentioned as a dimmable LED bulb on its packaging. And we already checked that the phase angle control method works for this. So I went on further to get an LED bulb which does not say it's dimmable to check the results anyways. This bulb glows normally on full pulse, but when I decrease the pulse width, it does not change the brightness, but then suddenly turns off when provided with even narrower pulse. So it means that these bulbs comes with an internal linear regulator circuitry which operates over a voltage range supply. Then I took an incandescent bulb. These are basically modeled as resistor only. And the dimmer circuit works like a charm on these ones.
I think that's all for today's video. So we started and saw how this circuit works in theory and then finally built one using very basic components from the shelf. I hope you found this video informative and helpful. If you have any questions or suggestions or you want to develop this project for yourself, then you can go to the Element 14 community page. There you will find all the resources I used for this project, including the code. So thank you for watching till the end. I'll see you in the next video.